Hello everyone and welcome back to GPU Price Watch 2025. I brought this series back in March and every month I have been gathering data about current GPU pricing so we can compare and see how prices have progressed, regressed, or gotten better over the course of this year. I really had no idea how things were going to go, but I'm happy to say that things are continuing to move in a consumer-friendly direction. Prices have continued to drop. We have MSRP pricing and even a couple GPUs that are below MSRP now. Amazing.
Excellent.
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. All right, a quick note on methodology and how I'm gathering this data. Before we begin, I'm using PC Part Picker, which is linked down in the video's description. Looking at any given graphics card, the RTX 5050 was added this month since it launched a few weeks back. I am averaging the lowest 10 prices that are available on PC Part Picker, or fewer than 10 if there are fewer than 10 listings. And I'm also verifying by going in and clicking through to the actual retailer website to make sure that these GPUs are available for purchase, ideally directly from the retailer themselves, but websites like Newegg and Amazon also have marketplace sellers. I am not including marketplace sellers if they have low feedback rating, or if they're brand new, or if they have any glaringly negative feedback, like, hey, this seller was selling this as a new GPU and what I received was clearly a used unit. Be careful when you're buying from third-party marketplace sellers from Amazon and Newegg and make sure you're double-checking the reviews for that reseller. And of course, the safest bet is to just buy products that are shipped from and sold by Amazon, Newegg, or whatever retailer you're shopping at. And here's a quick assessment of the updated chart for July. This is the June, and I'm going to show you the comparison. Look at the red areas over here on the lower right. Switching to July. Look, there's a lot more green. There's a lot more green. We even have a couple current gen cards, the 5060 Ti 8GB and the 9060 XT 8GB that are available for below MSRP. Of course, both of those cards have 8 gigs of VRAM, which has been heavily criticized because 8 gigs of VRAM can be a stopping point for you, depending on the games you're playing and the resolution. Some people play with an 8 gig card and they're just fine. If you want to be forward-looking, it's recommended to try to find a graphics card that has more than 8 gigs, ideally 12 or 16. Let's do a few quick hits here, recommended GPUs based on this data. If you're trying to stick to a budget and you have about $250 to spend on a GPU, the 5050 8GB is available at its $250 MSRP. However, the 9060 XT 8GB is a better graphics card and it has a $50 promo code at Newegg, giving it the honorary title of one of the few current generation cards that's available for below MSRP. Now this is supposedly a limited offer. It is an instant promo code though, so you don't have to worry about a mail-in rebate or anything like that. So it is good that AMD is offering some level of discount like this, especially to combat the RTX 5050 because the 9060 XT is absolutely a faster graphics card. Even if that promo code goes away though, this same graphics card is also selling at B&H straight up for $280. And that is also below MSRP, so that's pretty optimistic there. Since we're talking budget graphics cards, the Intel Arc B580 and B570 are always sort of in the discussion in this price range, but the prices have been high. I'm happy to say that the B580 dropped by $40 down to $260 for its lowest price this month. That actually makes the B570 a poor buy because it's still also sitting at that same lowest price of $260. But if you do want to get yourself some more VRAM in this price range, the B580 12GB is available. The next step up is going to be GPUs in the $300 to $350, maybe closer to $400 range. And here I would highly recommend trying to get yourself a 16GB card. The 5060 Ti 16GB was $430 last month. It is still $430 this month. That is the MSRP and it's widely available there. However, in this price range, for about $50 or $60 less, the 9060 XT 16GB still exists. That again, unfortunately, didn't have much price movement this month. It's still marked up by about $20, but that's not too bad. But again, if you're looking for that 16GB option in the $300 to $400 range, that's the card I would point you towards. If you're looking for a lot of bang for the buck in the mid-range, the 7900 XT has a 20GB VRAM buffer. That also had a nice price drop this month, going down to $700, which is fairly tantalizing. That is the last-gen card, though. So if you're looking for current-gen on the NVIDIA side, the 5070 at its $550 MSRP is a solid deal. 5070 Ti came down another $110 from the base price. That makes it only a $40 markup over MSRP, but it's still a little bit on the pricey side at $790. But on the AMD side, other than that 7900 XT deal, the 9070 16 gig is probably gonna be your best bet. Those came down $20 since last month, available for $600 straight up. All right, so that's sort of my quick hit assessment of the GPUs on this list that you might go for. Real quickly to go over, just from the top, since I have included the RTX 40 series up here, this is just to show that the 40 series, now that it's out of production, is continuing to get worse and worse in price. The RTX 40 series is not a good value at all if you're buying new right now. You might still be able to find good deals on 40 series cards on the used market, but of course, compare that to the lowest current prices for the RTX 50 series, because the 50 series is, generally speaking, a better option at roughly the same price. That's pretty much all I have to say about the 40 series for now. Buyer beware for pretty much all of those listings. The RTX 5050 came in this month, and I was actually expecting to see more of them at the $250 price. Not sure if there's any broader explanation for this, if these cards have sold well or if there's just not as many of them available, but there's lots of out of stock listings and maybe only one or two that you can buy for the $250 MSRP. By comparison, the RTX 5060 8GB variant at least has lots of listings. And the same goes for the RTX 50 Ti. Unfortunately, these 8GB cards, like I said, are not as desirable. I would only recommend an 8GB card if you're very, very confident that you're only going to be playing like simpler games that aren't going to max out the VRAM, or if you're only planning on playing at lower resolutions like 1080 and maybe 1440. But of course, even then, all of these NVIDIA 8GB options would definitely be outdone by the RTX 9060 XT at the $250 price, as long as that promo code holds. I kind of hope it does. The 9060 XT 8GB is a lot easier to recommend at $250 versus over $300. Now, the mid to upper range of the RTX 50 series from NVIDIA has been pretty much the holdout in terms of high pricing, especially the 5080 16GB, and of course the RTX 5090, which is always difficult to find. However, even though these are still marked up pretty significantly, $300 plus for the 5080 and $600 plus for the 5090, those lowest available prices have come down, so it's good to see that downward trend there, and of course the recommendation to you guys and to anyone who might be asking you guys for advice on what GPUs to buy is to never pay scalper pricing. Paying scalper pricing encourages the scalpers. It feeds them, allows them to procreate and make more scalpers, which I understand. They're born kind of like, you remember in like Lord of the Rings when they show how Saruman makes the orcs? Like that's how scalpers are born. More to the point though, for anyone who is looking to build a higher end system, you kind of have to bite the bullet for the 5080 or 5090, but again, I just say keep an eye out for those deals that bring it a lot closer to MSRP, because some retailers have been having deals where those do go up for sale, they just tend to sell out quickly. A few more notes on the AMD Radeon listings. The 7900 XT and 7900 XTX have been presented as good values with significant discounts, and it's good to see, I guess, that those discounts haven't completely gone away. My assessment had been that these GPUs are really limited on inventory, but apparently there are still some floating around. But yeah, between the two of these, the 7900 XT for $700 is a much better value than the 7900 XTX for $900. And then of course, for AMD's most appealing GPUs right now, the 9070 16GB and 9070 XT 16GB, most appealing asterisk, if they were selling for the MSRP, they have both dropped another $20. So we're looking at a $50 markup for the 9070 and a $120 markup for the 9070 XT. I would really like this low price change to accelerate. I'd like these to come back to MSRP a little bit more quickly, because that would give us way more options versus the 5070, 5070 Ti, and it might even put some downward pressure on the RTX 5080. Lastly, we have the Intel Arc listing, and just to reiterate, I'm really glad to see the B580 available for $260. This falls into the category of like being happy for a card that's selling for over MSRP, but it's just because it has been significantly over MSRP for quite some time. It was hovering around $300 to $310 for a while, but this now makes it a much more viable option at $260, and it helps keep Intel Arc GPUs in the conversation. On one final note, I removed the average price columns for March and April. You can still look at previous videos to see those. I was just trying to keep the spreadsheet from getting too out of control, making sure you guys could actually see all that data on the screen at once. As prices start to settle down, do you think there is still value in me doing this month-to-month look at the fluctuations, or do you think I should just focus on GPU deals or that sort of thing? I'd love to hear your feedback in the comment section down below, and I will post links to the best of the GPU deals that are available right now in the description as well. And also there's a link to my store down there at paulshardware.net where you can buy yourself some shirts, mugs, pint glasses, or other high quality merchandise to help support my channel. Thank you guys once again for watching this video. Hit the thumbs up button on the way out if you enjoyed it, and we'll see you all in the next one.